We're just sorry, don't drink and drive.
Do more people drink and drive this time of year?
They do. Well, it's, you know, it's the holidays. People celebrate. And alcohol's going to affect your decision-making. And when it does, it's too late.
It's funny, I find myself being more careful this time of year because I know I'm going out to a party or whatever. And
I wish more people thought like you.
You know, here's a cautionary tale for our time, since you mentioned people's judgment, and I'm already slurring a little bit. We did something similar to this once. It was just taking drinks and doing the breathalyzer deal. We weren't actually driving. We're taking it to a new level this year. But we got done with it, and we were both pretty drunk, and I was standing there in the parking lot, even though we'd signed forms and there were people there to drive us home. I was standing there in the parking lot thinking, you know, I'm probably all right. You know, I could drive home. I don't want to wait. That's the point, is you got to designate a driver before you start drinking.
Yeah, that's important. It's pre-planning. That's all it is, pre-planning. Make that part of your celebration. Pre-plan. Find that designated driver beforehand. Hey, you know what a lot of bars do now? Is they give you free drinks for that designated driver. Free non-alcoholic drinks.
Why am I not drinking? Should I drink some more?
Have another drink.
Okay.
Michael, do we still have a caller on the line? Carrie. Carrie, you're on with Armstrong and Getty on Talk 650 KSTE. Good morning.
Hello?
You're on the air. You're on the air. What can we
do
for
you? I weigh 110 and I'm 5'5". And I'm just wondering, can I even have one drink and drive?
She's 5'5", 110. She's wondering, can she even have one drink and drive?
Oh, yeah. She can have one drink. We're looking at three drinks. This is 80 proof liquor, 1¼ ounces. So three drinks.
So three drinks, you're over the line. Two, you're iffy.
Yeah, two, you're iffy. Three, you're over the line.
Oh, okay.
Now, all that depends on what's in your stomach, a lot of other things. Females process alcohol differently, so that's, you know.
Thank God.
Yeah.
That's what got me through college.
So is that like a timeline on that? I'm actually going to a couple of holiday parties, and I never really, it's hard to tell, you know. Is that like two drinks in like 2 hours or something?
Yeah, what is the time frame on that? That's a good question. If you're going to have two drinks, you're talking about two drinks back-to-back? And then, how long does it take to wear off?
The numbers I gave is over a 2-hour period.
Okay.
And what you need to understand, alcohol comes out of your body 0.02% every hour. Here's the problem. Where do we live? We have colleges all around us. Do they think in terms of one beer? Two beers?
No.
How'd you used to think?
I either drink to drink or I don't at all. I either drink like it's my job or I don't.
Yeah, see, that's
the way I always look at it.
That's the problem. The college, there's a lot of college guys out there, they drink to party.
Yeah.
They drink to get blasted, to get wasted. And that's the problem. And since alcohol only dissipates out of your system 0.02% an hour, say you party and you're a 2-0 when you go to sleep. You are a 2-0. That's not uncommon for a college student that's partying, having fun. He goes to sleep at 3 o'clock in the morning. He gets up at 5 o'clock in the 8 o'clock in the morning, 5 hours later. What's his alcohol content?
I don't know.
It's 1-0.
Woo.
He jumps in the car, he drives, he gets pulled over, spends the rest of the day in jail.
You know, when we did this last time, I remember we stopped drinking, and like 45 minutes later, our blood alcohol level was like 0.4, 0.6 higher than it was before. So you're still absorbing after you stop drinking.
Oh, definitely. Definitely. You're still absorbing. The body's still processing that alcohol.
Which, of course, makes you wonder why you had that last drink anyway. Because you go home and you go to bed, and you're college guys. You're at your drunkest while you're asleep. It doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, it doesn't.
And that's where you're waking up in the morning and chewing your arm off. But anywho.
Oh, my God, what have I done? Is there any chance I'll blow anything now? Should we give it a try, or is it too recent?
It might still be too recent, but we can definitely give it a try.
How's that vodka, smooth?
Yeah, it actually is very good. Svedka vodka.
Do you want to do a body shot? I'll take my shirt off.
Oh, God, I got a visual. That's scary, people.
We've got Richard on the line. Richard, you're on with Armstrong and Getty on Talk 650 KSTE. Good morning.
Hey, are you guys making a video of this?
No, we are not videoing it, but we probably should be.
Yeah, we should be. I should have brought my camera. I mean, because we can describe the cones going down one after the other, but it'd be fun to watch.
Well, shucks. I was going to buy it if he was.
Yeah,
we'll think of that next year. Maybe we'll make a video and sell it for charity or something like that.
Hey, let's give it a try. Let's see if we can register any alcohol.
Okay, Joe's blowing into the breathalyzer after his first big drink of the morning to see what kind of level he's got.
Here we go. 0.52?
0.05.
Already?
Yeah, we're moving up slowly. You're still processing that one drink you drank.
You just had one, though, right?
Yeah.
You know, I know it was a strong drink.
It's 0.05, though, right?
Yeah, it's 0.05.
And the legal limit is?
0.08. No. Yeah, 0.08. It's 0.05 is what it's
ready. Oh, I see.
Ah.
So you got a little ways to go. Well, have another drink.
Why don't I do the... Okay.
Come on, Sally.
Oh, jiminy Christmas.
Does your husband drink? Come on.
0.05.
I can't believe that I'm on flu medication and have to pass this
all right,
up.
Let's get a clarification here.
Okay. It was an 0.05. But see, when we stop somebody, we wait for a little while to make sure they don't have any residue in their mouth. So what we probably got a reading is a little mouth residue. But it's just a matter of time.
Well, should I?
Yeah, take another drink.
Oh, God. Man.
Come on, Scott and I'll start looking really good. We'll get prettier and prettier.
Scott already looks pretty good. Here we go. You know, Scott's going to be taking me home, too. Do the math. The wife will be out, you know, running around.
It's early in the morning. You should be drinking a 40 out of a sack. That's generally what I see people drinking this time of day. Too strong? More orange juice there?
Yeah, by the way, is there going to be a place I can take a whiz later?
There's a couple trees over here.
You'll be drunk. You'll just be standing in the middle of the parking lot swaying back and forth, writing your name on the...
That's a good point. You know, I don't know what the breath machine says, but I'm starting to feel the ounces go down.
Are you really?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Well, I've drank like 6 ounces of vodka in the last 20 minutes.
And no breakfast to speak of.
My Pop-Tarts.
Boy, Pop-Tarts and vodka. That sounds good. Not just any man could or would do that. Okay, as soon as Joe gets somewhat hammered, we're going to put him back in the car and have him drive through the cones and see how he does compared to his sober trip through the cones.
I don't feel so good.
All right, well, maybe we ought to take a break in case Joe has to vomit.
No, I'm not there yet.
Okay, Michael, we're going to take a break. You can call us, by the way, at 576-1KST, 576-1578, or #650 on your AT&T wireless. We're learning a little bit about how alcohol affects you and how it relates to the breathalyzer in terms of drinking and driving, which you shouldn't do. Armstrong and Getty on Talk 650 KSTE. Good morning.
It's one hell of a show. Armstrong and Getty on Talk 650 KSTE.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm.
The holiday season.
Fun in your morning. This is Talk 650 KSTE.
Ho, ho, ho! We are festive here. We're Armstrong and Getty. We're live in the Cal Expo parking lot where Joe's been hammering down vodka and orange juices. And he's going to take a ride in the highway patrol car with the highway patrolman to have his reflexes tested and whatnot.
My brain is sending me a message. Wait a minute.
Beep, 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 beep.
You've had several drinks. Yes, indeed. Setting in.
Let's take Veronica's phone call real quick before we talk to the highway patrolman again. Veronica, you're on with Armstrong Getty on Talk 650 KSTE. Good morning.
Good morning, you guys. I have a question for the CHP, but I was also thinking that Joe could do a body shot off of Jack's head.
Do a body shot off my head? That would work.
You could take your shirt off.
Listen, I'm going to puke before it's done anyway. Don't rush it.
Here's my question for the officer. I've heard that if you are drinking, even if you're under a .08, and you drove, and you got in an accident, even if it wasn't your fault, you could be prosecuted for drunk driving.
Yeah, you can. And what people don't realize, there are actually two laws. There's one law where everybody's under the influence at an 08 or above. Everybody. And then there's a law that there's some people that shouldn't be drinking at all. That when they're under an 08, they're still under the influence. Usually those are the people that haven't had anything to drink, or they're not social. They're just sociable drinkers or don't drink often. And they can't process alcohol very well. And just a couple drinks are going to put them under the influence, and they're going to act like they're totally drunk.
So if somebody was weaving around and you pull them over and they say, I had one wine cooler, you could still give them a DUI?
You can, but that's very, very, very rare. Usually it's medication included. Have you taken any medicine?
No, sir.
See, that's why I'm not drinking, because I'm on flu medication. I didn't know what that would do to me.
That may affect you. It just depends. It just depends. Usually what we're talking about is we have someone that maybe doesn't drink at all, never drank, turned 21, went out and partied, had 3-4 beers. They wouldn't be an 08 quite if they're, you know, good size. And but they're still affected.
Right.
They're they still can't walk. They're exhibiting signs like if they were an 08 or above.
So practice, kids.
Practice. But even practice, that's not going to be the solution.
Right.
All right, speaking of which, I'm in the mood for some field sobriety tests.
Okay, let's...
What do y'all say?
Let's check Joe out and see if he's drunk yet. Now, how much have you had to drink?
I've had
you forgot already?
No, I've had three.
Oh, just two.
I had a third.
Don't argue with the officer.
No, listen, Ossifer. I had three. Yeah, Officer Mike agrees with me. Officer Nick, you need to pay attention. Now, listen, I've had three. Uh-oh, surliness.
You're sneaking him in now, huh?
You hold up two fingers.
Oh, no. All right, listen, let's do a couple of field sobriety tests here, and then I need to drive the course. I'm in the mood to do a little nutty driving.
By the way, during the commercials, they did the first test, and they were going to look at Joe's eyes, and they asked him to take off his sunglasses, and he dropped them. And both of the highway patrolmen smiled. I suppose that's usually a good sign if somebody can, you know, drops their keys or their glasses or whatever.
Yeah, the fumble rooskies usually are a good sign.
All right, listen, speaking of which, the ceremonial handing of the keys to Scott. There you go, Scotty boy. Excellent. All right, little field sobriety.
What I want you to do for me, just put your feet all the way together, feet and toes all the way together, hands down to your side. Okay, what I'm going to do, I'm going to check your eyes and make sure. This is what we call a nystagmus test, and basically it's the inability of your eyes to track smoothly, and what we look for is the jerkiness in your eyes. All right, well, we'll do that right now.
Touch your heel to the middle of your back.
No, that's a test.
Okay, well, I said, like, tip my finger here.
Yeah, watch my eyes, Jack. See me.
And what we're going to look for is if you have smooth motion or not. Okay, now open your eyes just a little bit higher. There you go. Just so we can see the eyes.
Okay.
As we increase the speed, you'll notice that his eyes aren't going to quite track. And right. As we go to the way to the side here, and he tries to follow, you'll see that inability, his eyes are already jerky.
And usually it'd be a smooth transition if you're sober.
Well, let's see somebody sober. I mean, because that's hard. Here, do it on Officer Nick.
Yeah, do it on him.
Let me see that.
Okay.
Do it all the way to the side, because that was the hard part.
Oh, yeah, that's much better than you were doing.
Nah, he thinks he's so hot. Mr. CHB. All right, shall we do a breathalyzer?
Sure, that sounds good. Well, get it out, Mike.
And then a little driving.
You have a rosy glow about you.
Thank you.
Your cheeks are a little rosy.
Thank you very much.
Getting bigger.
We'll be Teddy Kennedy over here before too long.
Okay, we're going to do the old breathalyzer. I've never had to do this, thank God, like, you know, being pulled over or anything like
God,
that.
I have got this incredible desire to come on to somebody. Are there any women here?
How's Scott looking?
Not good enough. Honey, if you're listening, come on to Cal Expo. Let's revitalize the relationship.
Okay, let's do the breathalyzer.
There we go. He's blown into the breath machine here, and let's see what we registered 05 earlier, and hey, there we go. And we're going to register here. Let's see, it's processing here. 0.04. That's probably a more true calculation
of what
the alcohol content is right now than his first test.
I had mouth residue going. So, a 0.04. So, I'm
halfway
buzzed. I'm buzzed. Shall we drive?
Sure.
All right, let's get in the police Volvo. Okay.
While you're getting in the car, let's get traffic real quick with Marilyn Nelson on Talk 650 KSTE. How's it look out there, Marilyn? Thank God Joe's not on the road.
Yeah, no kidding, but somebody just like Joe may have been already. Westbound on Highway 50 approaching Bradshaw, somebody just drove right off the roadway through the fence and down into the drainage canal. Now a couple of tow trucks are out there. One is back down into the drainage canal trying to hook up and pull it on out. All the lanes on the freeway are clear, so you'll find the action over onto the shoulder. We do have an accident just reported at Fair Oaks, Manzanita, heading over to the triangle to check that situation out. And if you're heading into the mountains, looks good right now on 50 and 80, but have those chains handy for the weekend. Airborne on the Talk 650 traffic team, I'm Marilyn Nelson.
Marilyn, it is 18 before 9 on Talk 650. It's going to be sunny and 58 today. It's sunny and 48 right now. Joe, you've got quite a standard to match. Somebody drove through a guardrail into a ditch off Fair Oaks, so... Joe is now in the Highway Patrol Volvo, and you've been drinking, and here he goes.
You ready?
Yeah.
All right,
what's the plan here? Officer Mike, you want to do a little play-by-play?
Sure.
All right, great.
Okay, we're going to start from the course and go through the cone pattern here. And
where's the red light, yellow light, green light? I like to watch the drag racing on ESPN2. Here we go.
He's slurring.
Okay, we're off to a start here. Oh, he's a little late on his turns already here.
Oh, that's bull.
He hasn't hit a cone yet.
Heartbreaking.
What are you, my wife? Quit criticizing my driving.
Okay, going through the Serpentine. It hasn't hit
braking
the cone.
Braking hard, hard steering.
Oh!
I don't think he knocked it over, though.
Stopped right on the cone. I mean, didn't knock it over. Really
good. Parallel parking maneuver here.
Now the parallel parking.
And I'm the master of this, as all males are and must be. Anybody who can't parallel park is no man! How good was that?
Wow, that was pretty good.
Outstanding job. You
know? All right, of course, I just blew a what, a .4?
.04.
.04, right.
Yeah, so you're...
So, most people, a man your size, can still probably be in control.
What kind of crack was that?
you're thin. You're thin.
I appreciate that. How'd that do? Did I knock over any cones?
No, but you were pretty wide. I mean, you gave them a good berth before when you went around them.
Hey, listen, Richard Head. They set the cones up at a certain width.
Well, you didn't go that way through the first time.
Okay, all right. You know, you've got a stopwatch. You ought to be timing me.
Oh, yeah, that's a good idea.
I say more drinking.
Okay, we got Ken on the line. You're on with Armstrong Getty on Talk 650 KSTE. Good morning, Ken. What can we do for you?
Hey, good morning, guys. I was just calling up because I'm hearing you doing this thing, and I think it's so important that you do it, especially during this time of the year. Best thing I feel about it is I don't drink, so I know I'll never have to go through that embarrassment or anything like it, but
sure.
I think you perform a public service. And the last thing I want to do is just wish you and yours a happy holiday season and hope that everything goes well for you over your vacation and during this holiday season.
Hey, thank you very much, Ken. You're one of our favorite callers. And,
yeah, absolutely. I'm just saying this because I've been drinking, but Ken, we think very, very highly of you, and we appreciate you listening.
Thanks a lot, guys.
I love you.
Listen, is that what you said?
You said now. You
said listen.
As we were leading up to this, you know, I was thinking the drinking at 8 o'clock in the morning. That's not real great. The being hungover at 1:30 in the afternoon is really objectionable. But what I really, really was dreading was the inevitable mocking by my coworkers. Look, I volunteered for this duty. Oh, there's Officer Mike again. He really enjoys doing that course.
I know, we've done this before where Joe and I have both drank, and then everybody enjoys making fun of you when you start slurring. Well, no kidding, I'm slurring. I'm drinking straight vodka.
All right, Officer Nick, you pull somebody over. What are you looking for? You start, you know, maybe you got a report, maybe you see him swerving. What are you looking for?
Well, first of all, if he's got a drink in his hand like you, that's a bad sign.
Yeah, here, take the mic. I got some drinking to do.
Yeah, that's the key right there. He's got that beer in his hand, that 40 in his hand. Yeah, that's a good indication
there. You ever pulled over anybody that are actually drinking at the time?
Oh, yeah, I've had them offer them to me.
You're kidding me.
Oh, no.
Well, you got to be smashed to think that's a good idea.
Oh, no, that happens, though. That happens. It really does. Yeah, I'm looking for everything. I'm looking for a slurred speech like you've got right now. I'm looking for red and watery eyes. I'm looking for a slow coordination. There's quite a few things we're looking for. We're not just looking for one thing in itself.
You can smell it, can't you, when you come to the car?
Oh, definitely. Definitely. Vodka, you can smell it. You can smell it, and but the slurring and all that helps out quite a bit, too.
Let's watch Officer Mike. Cop. I'm just going to go with cop from here on out. Oh, that's Ross. That's Engineer Ross is trying it out.
See, you were giving the cones a good 6 feet of leeway when you were going around them.
And he was, oh, look at that. Look, he tipped a cone.
He was going awful fast.
I didn't do that. Yeah, I was kind of driving deliberately. Officer Mike was criticizing my hard braking as well. Little jerky.
Did you drink that other drink already?
Yeah, buddy.
Wow, so how much have you had?
What do you reckon,
Nick?
Well, you tell me.
It's four good, solid, big old drinks.
No.
In the space of, God dang it, quit messing with me.
Well, it's hard to say how you count them because you're putting so much vodka in there, you know. Like, if you're at a bar, you might have had seven drinks at a bar.
Yeah, I suppose so.
I'm just waiting for you to wrap your lips around the bottle and just suck the bottle dry.
God.
What time of day do you find most people driving drunk?
Hey, way to
when
go,
do you catch,
Ross!
When do you catch people most?
A lot of times, it's all hours of the day now, but the majority of them are between, I'd say, about 10 o'clock and 3, 4 o'clock in the morning, right in those areas. That's when the bars close. That's when they're operating. So that's usually when we find them.
Hey. Jack, have we explained what we're doing here? Have we reset for the good folks?
I have, but we could do it again. Joe's getting a little lit. He's drinking vodka and orange juice. Heavy on the vodka, low on the orange juice. He's not a big citrus fan.
Holy crap. Ross, what are you trying to prove over there, buddy?
Is he supposed to do that?
Engineer Ross is a drunk, apparently.
Ross just screamed by at about 100 miles an hour.
Hey, how do you feel about another sobriety test?
Okay, just a second.
Come on, let's do it.
Joe is drinking
Why
vodka.
Why are you such a killjoy?
Joe is drinking vodka and then driving around in the highway patrol car around these cones, and we're seeing how, as he gets drunker, how it affects him. You're cruising right along there, Ross. Has he got a little pickup?
Yeah, this is a marvelous driving little Volvo. It really handles very, very well.
Yeah, that's a cool-looking car. Those are expensive, right, those new Volvo Highway Patrol cars?
Oh, they're not too expensive. We got a pretty good deal. Ford just bought Volvo not too long ago, so it's a Ford product.
I did not know that.
You know what Ford stands for.
Fix it again, Tony. that's a King of the Hill joke. So what do we need to do? Joe is getting more and more hammered. When is it time for another test or whatever?
Anytime, actually. We'll give it a little time. Let that alcohol
soak in a little bit.
Let it soak in.
Well, I'll tell you what. Let's take a break. And if you want to mix another drink and sip on it a little bit during the commercials, just, you know, the party's almost over. You got to get one more in quick before the bar closes.
All right, if you say so.
And then we'll put him back in the car and see how he does, see how many cones he hits this time. For Armstrong and Getty, we're in the Cal Expo parking lot. Joe's just hammered.
Not yet.
Oh, by the end of the 10 o'clock hour, he'll have his shirt off and he'll be screaming at people. For Armstrong and Getty on Talk 650 KSTE. Oh, here's traffic with Marilyn Nelson.
Well, Jack, you might need a little drink there, too. I hope Jack has a very, very smooth trip this weekend as he is heading out of town. And if you're heading to the airport right now, we're looking great on Interstate 5 with absolutely no delays as you head out through Sacramento International Airport. We do have one injury accident westbound on Fair Oaks Boulevard approaching California that's blocking the right-hand lane. And then westbound on Fair Oaks Boulevard, actually westbound on Highway 50 approaching Bradshaw, we had a vehicle drive through the perimeter fence of the freeway down into the drainage canal. Looks like they have just retrieved the vehicle from the water. There's a lot of activity over on the shoulder as you pass through Tier Overcrossing heading towards Bradshaw, but no traffic lanes are blocked, and we do have traffic driving by it pretty quickly. No chain requirements just yet in the mountains, but take them with you. Airborne on the Talk 650 traffic team, I'm Marilyn Nelson.
Need to get away? Head to Albertsons, where you can buy Heavenly Lake Tahoe adult lift ticket vouchers for just $49. See store for details. Hey, it's your life. Albertsons, it's your store.
I'm Tom Sullivan for Gazzetta and Company Fine Jewelers.
And I'm Kitty O'Neill. We think Gazzetta is a winner, but so do Sacramentans. Ever since Sacramento Magazine has had a Best of Sacramento poll, Gazzetta and Company Fine Jewelers has been a winner, no exception this year.
It's no surprise, Kitty. Gazzetta has the best selection of designer jewelry, 18-karat gold, platinum, diamonds, and engagement rings.
And I like dealing directly with the experts that you know and trust. The Gazzetta family's been here for years, and now there are two stores for more convenience and more service for you.
That's right, two locations to find that perfect gift. Gazzetta and Company Fine Jewelers' new store in Roseville in the TJ Maxx Plaza, and the original store, 805 Howe Avenue Plaza in Sacramento.
You'll find beautiful things that any woman would be thrilled to receive. Great stuff for men, too.
Gazzetta has special holiday hours this week, Monday through Friday until 7, Saturday until 6, and they will be open Sunday, Christmas Eve, at 10 a.m.
Gazzetta and Company Fine Jewelers in Sacramento at 805 Howe Avenue.
And now serving the Roseville Granite Bay Area in the TJ Maxx Plaza on Douglas Boulevard.
Hi, Armstrong and Getty here for Sleep Train. This holiday season, Sleep Train would like to thank you for making us your choice for the best mattress store in Northern California this past year.
Sleep Train is going to give you a free gift when you purchase a premium mattress set.
You can choose your free gift, as a matter of fact. Choose from a free heavy-duty bed frame, two free deluxe pillows, or a free electric train set.
And right now at Sleep Train, 6 months free financing with no down payment, no monthly payments, and no interest for 6 months.
That's a heck of a present right there, but remember, you get a choice of those three great gifts when you buy any Sealy Posturepedic, Simmons Beautyrest, or Stearns & Foster mattress set.
Yeah, once again, you either get a free heavy-duty bed frame, or you can choose two free deluxe pillows, or, maybe for the kids, a free electric train set.
And, of course, Sleep Train guarantees you the low price, so you know you haven't overpaid. And buy a bed today, you'll sleep on it tonight.
Free same-day delivery at Sleep Train.
Now, they'll ask you, where'd you get the brilliant idea to come to Sleep Train? Tell them from Armstrong and Getty on Talk 650. When you go to Sleep Train.
It's the holiday season, the time when we create more throwaway materials than any other time of the year. We get it.
Look, a card from the kids.
We give it. And we throw it. Just because we create it all doesn't mean we have to throw it all away. Recycle. With Sacramento County's curbside program, you can use your convenient mixed recycling container. Recycle your holiday cards, wrapping paper, and gift boxes. And don't forget your cans, bottles, and newspapers. Oh, and don't forget, phone books can also be recycled. With Sacramento County's curbside program, you can make the holiday season the season of recycling. Just take what would have been your holiday waste to the curb. You can recycle gift boxes, wrapping paper, old calendars, advertising mail, magazines, catalogs, and your cardboard. For more information, visit sacgreenteam.com.
Join the Green Team, Sacramento County's Green Team.
If this is your life during the holidays,
breakfast, drive, shop, sew, cook, pick up, dress up, make list, invite, write cards, polish, decorate, do hair, school play, wrap even more, nap, cook, clean, taste, headache.
Then Albertsons is your store.
Shop simple. Appetizers to go, quick, party trays, fabulous. Hot turkey dinner, poinsettia, centerpiece, masterpiece. Home style pies, photo processing, bonus buy savings, joyous smiles.
Stop by Albertsons for holiday savings throughout the store. And while you're there, make sure and register to win a vacation for two to Puerto Vallarta, Mexico on Alaska Airlines, including a stay at the fabulous La Jolla de Mismaloya, one of the world's 100 leading hotels. Deadline to register is December 26th. See store for details. Albertsons. From bonus buy savings to quick fix and ideas, from gift wrap to gift baskets and turkey with all the trimmings, we have just what you need to make the holidays special. Hey, it's your life. Albertsons. It's your store.
Now, back to Armstrong and Getty.
Yep, we've been doing great talk radio since the late 1900s.
Check it out, only on the talk station, Talk 650 KSDE.
It is 8:54, 6 before 9, Armstrong and Getty. Happy holidays. We're in the parking lot of Cal Expo, where Joe's been drinking vodka for about an hour, and
As usual,
same old Joe.
Another 9 o'clock Friday, you know.
And we're getting ready to put him back in the highway patrol car and have him drive through the cones and see how he does this time.
Officer Nick has just made a very, very good point.
Hey, whose job was it to bring the chips and the dip and the peanuts and all that stuff?
Yeah, no kidding.
Where's the trail mix?
What kind of party is this? Or
the salty trail mix.
Mozzarella sticks.
Yeah, I need some cheese sticks or some chicken fingers.
What kind of bar is this? Hey, we are taking your phone calls, by the way, at 576-1-KSD. 576-1578. We're going to be out here all next hour. If you've got any questions you've always wanted to ask a highway patrolman about the whole drinking and driving DUI breathalyzer thing, they can answer your questions at 576-1KST. And we want to see how drunk Joe is at this point?
Sure.
He's had quite a bit of vodka, sir. You might want to keep an eye on him. I think he's got a problem. You might want to have your nightstick handy.
There you go. I got my cuffs out, so
hey,
we got it in a
screw you, bald man. All right, no. Honestly, if you're listening, you're interested in this sort of thing, I'm definitely buzzed. I'm starting to feel it. Time for a breathalyzer. Hey, Officer Mike.
You're swaying. You're visibly swaying.
I just feel the music in me, man.
Isn't he visibly swaying, Scott?
Oh, yeah, he's like one of those Macy's Days, boat, like those balloons.
Now, wait a minute. I'm trying to throw a breathalyzer.
Hey, officer.
All right, here we go. Let's try again. All right.
5 seconds. Keep going. All righty.
It's just going to say,
this is exciting, isn't
arrest
it?
Now.
Why is it smoking? 0.12, but you did just have some drinks, so... Like I said, it's some residual mouth alcohol, so you're probably around an 08 right about now, probably 07, 08.
Let's do some driving.
All right, here we go.
So you think he's about right at the legal limit?
Where did we leave the car? There it is.
Yeah, he's right at the legal limit. He's probably, if we did some field sobriety tests, you would see a definite difference.
Well, let's do some then.
Hey, bring it on.
Come on, tough guy. You want to test me? Let's do it.
What is your first typical field sobriety test that you're going to do to a guy?
Typical? I'd probably do a walk in a straight line or standing on one foot. Ah, that's the one. Let's do it.
Big fan of that. Let's have him walk a straight line or something.
You want to do it, Mike? Go for it.
Okay, well, I'll dance a straight line, man. I'll do the Irish dancing.
What we need you to do, put your foot right in front of your other like this and stand with your hands to your side. Okay, right in front of you, all the way, right on the white line. There you go. All right.
Easy.
When I tell you what I want
you... got a date? Take your time.
Okay, now, when I tell you, I want you to walk 9 steps out with your hands to your side.
Yeah.
Turn around and walk 9 steps back.
All right, 9.
Okay.
I got it.
Heel to toe on the line.
No problem. Here we go. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
Pretty wobbly.
4. I'm like an Olympic athlete.
Now, would you say he looks drunk?
Yeah, six. Right now, one of the directions was to keep his hands to the sides. Obviously, he can't
well,
do
they're
that.
At my
it looks
sides.
Like an airplane.
They're to the sides.
They're still attached to his shoulders.
8, 9. There we go.
Counting. His heels and toes aren't exactly together, either.
Nah, right.
No, they're not.
One,
no, they're not.
2. Oh,
yeah,
boy.
He's definitely showing some signs
3,
now.
4.
He's not the fleet of foot he used
5,
to be, I tell you that.
6.
It was ugly before, but
well,
now it's even
uglier.
Well, it
was in 76 that I won my gold medal in the floor exercise. 7. 8. 9. I'm not in Olympic shape anymore.
Yeah.
That wasn't so good, really.
The walk in the straight line didn't work so good. Yeah, do the 1 foot thing. This will be fun.
All right.
This one is going to be standing on 1 foot. What we're going to have you do is count from 1,001 to 1,030 with your hands to your side and your foot raised.
You slurred there. 1,001 to what?
1,030.
Okay. With my foot raised?
So 30 seconds with 1 foot in the air, basically.
What am I over here?
Hands to your side.
Come on, Baryshnikov, do it.
All right. 1,001, 1,002, 1,003, 1,004, 1,000.
He's going over. There he goes.
I made it. 1,070. You know, I picked my bad foot. Let me switch. No, that was better.
That's not my lucky foot.
1,007, 1,008, 1,009, 1,010, 1,011. Oh, man. I'm glad I don't have to put on my shoes.
Oh, my God. It's unbelievable. I mean, really, I wouldn't think you were so drunk you couldn't stand on 1 foot for 5 seconds.
That's frustrating. 1,001, 1,002, 1,003. No, it's easy when I'm doing this with the mic up and the...
More to come next hour, and then we're going to put Joe back in the car and see how he does.
I got to do some driving, man.
Well, we got to do the news.
Why?
These are the rules.
Nobody cares about the news.
Cuff him during the news, would you?
Scott, pour me a drink, would you?
Armstrong and Getty, Talk 650.
Calling names. They never let poor Rudy join in any reindeer game.
A clear channel radio station. Talk 650 KSTE. They're out of their minds. Please leave a message. Armstrong and Getty, only on the Talk Station. The all-new Talk 650 KSTE.
Welcome and good morning. Happy holidays. Armstrong and Getty on Talk 650 KSTE.
I'm out of my mind.
Time is 9:07, 7 past 9. We are broadcasting live from the parking lot of Cal Expo. Joe has been drinking vodka and orange juice for the last hour, and we're with the Highway Patrol, and we're doing a little drinking and driving and how alcohol affects your coordination and your ability to drive and when you're too drunk to drive. And we're learning a lot about it during the holiday season when, unfortunately, a lot of people do drink and drive.
And I hadn't noticed it till I made my way to the Porta Wizard, but I'd like to welcome all the people sitting here in their cars watching this. How you doing, folks? That's nice.
It's good to have an audience.
Great.
Thanks for coming out. We'd like to thank Cal Expo for letting us use the parking lot and risking their bushes and light poles as Joe drives around in the CHP vehicle a little drunk. How drunk are we now?
We're coming on to strangers drunk. We're expressing, like, really embarrassing affection toward our friends drunk.
Are you telling the boss off drunk? He's right here.
You know, I do have a thing or two I'd like to tell the boss. Look at him talking to Ross over there like, I think nothing else is going on. Son of a bitch.
Okay, let's do the breathalyzer and see how drunk you are now. And then we got to put you back in the car and have you drive through the cones and see how you do.
Now, before I do that, I've just had a sip or two of my drink. Officer Nick, residue in the mouth can give a false high, but that's not going to get a driver off, right?
No, it's not. Usually, it takes some time for us to actually determine if someone's going to jail, is under the influence. So we're going to talk to them outside the car and do some field sobriety tests, and then the amount of time that mouth alcohol will dissipate. So that's not even an issue when they give this test. Just right now for this control test, since it's so soon after the drink, yeah, that we're registering some high numbers.
So you're going to give me a little credit for extra numbers. All right, here we go, Officer Mike.
But so it's not just you, you can't count backwards from 10 and all of a sudden you're off to jail. There's a bunch of tests and you make sure that...
Oh, no, we look for the totality of the circumstances, the driving, the objective symptoms. Right now it says an 098. That's probably more accurate. It's probably right on right now. That's counting the number of drinks, how slender you are.
appreciate that. Appreciate that, Officer Neck. You're a sensitive man.
You got your goggles on. The officer's got his beer goggles on.
But it's the totality. We're looking for objective symptoms, how their coordination is, how their speech is, their driving. We're looking for everything. We're not just looking for one thing only.
You know, it strikes me. Sorry, Jack, but wait a minute, would you?
I'll let the drunk guy talk.
It probably isn't real difficult to tell if somebody's been having a couple of drinks, is it?
No, it's not real difficult. However, you have some alcoholics out there who operate normally at an 08 to 1.5. Unfortunately, it still affects their ability to perceive hazards, and, you know, they might not see that little six-year-old kid crossing the street and not stop in time.
What is it like once you've decided, like, you pull over Joe, he just blew what he blew, and he's going off to jail. Where's he headed, and what's that like?
First of all, he gets some nice little bracelets, the handcuffs.
God, I've never been in cuffs. That would be
horrible. Never been in cuffs?
No.
Oh, come on.
Not even at home.
Well, hey. Yeah, well, we put the handcuffs on, and then we take it down to county jail.
Why don't you cuff him? I got a couple of things I'd like to work out.
But we'll take you down to county jail, and then you have to submit to another chemical test, either a blood test or a breath test. And at that point, if you're still over the legal limit, you're going to spend at least 4 hours in jail.
Uh-huh.
And I tell you, it's not the cleanest, it's not the nicest smelling room there is. You're in there with a bunch of drunks.
Yeah, we've ridden with the police before, and we've seen it on like a Saturday night, and it's ugly in there. And there's people, you know, they've thrown up, and there's people fighting, and it's ugly. It's not a place you want to spend the night.
Oh, no, it isn't. It isn't. That should be, that should tell you in itself that, hey, don't get drunk. You don't want to go to jail because you don't want to spend the night with those kind of people.
Plus, the magistrate doesn't work on Saturday nights, does he? So you're looking at extended stay.
Oh, yeah, extended stay.
Once again, that word was extended.
Hey, hey, drinky, let's put you in the car and send you through the paces.
Yeah, all right. What was my breathalyzer again? I don't remember.
It's an 09.
That's enough.
Yep.
Okay, here we go.
You're walking with the side-to-side shuffle now. The take big wide steps to make sure you don't go down walk.
No. It's my John Wayne thing, man.
Okay, that's your John Wayne walk.
Take another sip before I get in the car.
There you go, one for the road. Here's to you. May the road rise up to meet you.
And it may. There you go. Here, we'll get in the car.
How about uncontrollable giggling? Is that a sign?
That definitely is a sign. He's there.
No.
He's there.
I just love life. I'm just a happy man. Here you go, Officer Mike.
Again, we're in the Cal Expo parking lot. Joe's hammered, and he's in the Highway Patrol vehicle now. He's going to drive through the cones. Did it a couple times earlier when he was sober, so we know what the standard is.
I couldn't find the buckle of the seatbelt. That may be one of the signs. Here you go.
Jesus. Officer, be ready to reach over and grab the wheel.
All right, here we go.
Here he goes.
You know, I've got the urge to set some kind of a record here.
Okay, yeah, really get after it.
Drive really aggressively.
There you go, really get after it. That thing goes 140, they told us, so you got plenty of headroom.
We're about to find out.
All right, you got plenty of headroom.
Here he goes.
Here he goes, taking off through the cones.
Here we go.
And we're off.
Didn't hit the first cone. Hit the second one.
Oh, a cone.
Hit the
that
second
was the
cone.
Wind. The wind blew it over. Come on, Riff.
Okay. Didn't hit any cones through the serpentine. Oh, hit a one. Good stop. A little abrupt.
Not too bad. Not too bad through the chicane.
And he did hit one
cone. You gotta understand, I'm a really, really, really good driver.
Here we go. Now a little parallel park. Once again, the Wrigley Field experience coming into play.
I'm going to do it fast. I don't have time to waste. Bingo!
Bingo. Actually, the parallel parking was pretty good. He stopped at the end of the serpentine right up against the cone.
Oh, so you just accidentally honked the horn.
That's not a good sign. You ran over a total of two cones. How do you think that went compared to when he was sober?
It's getting worse. It's getting worse. Wow, and definitely, just think, that could be two kids.
It could
be two kids. So, it's only going to get worse as his alcohol level goes up.
All right, quit trying to bring me down. Now, that first cone, that's a little embarrassing because that part of the course is really easy.
Yeah. Yeah, that is a little embarrassing. You might be drunk. I think you have one more drink, and we'll let that settle in, and then by the end of the hour, you should be in good shape.
You know, somebody has got to give me sexual gratification before this is all done.
I don't know if you want to draw straws or
576-1KSD.
Oh, yeah.
We're in the Cal Expo parking lot. I think there's some carnies out here.
You know, we do occasionally talk to horny, middle-aged, you know, ex-wives on our radio show. Perhaps they'd like to come out.
All right, we're going to take a break. You can call right now if you'd like to ask a question. Talk to a highway patrolman now as opposed to, like, on a Saturday night at 1 o'clock when you've had too much to drink. Find out what the rules are. How does it work? What are the paces they're going to run you through?
You know what we ought to do, Captain Sober, is review that little chart for, you know, how much you weigh and how many drinks you can get away with before you're over the limit.
That is a good idea, because not everybody's as svelte as you. It's a different standard for everyone.
That's a good point. I'm like Allie McBeal over here. Allie McBeal in a flannel shirt.
Our phone number is 576-1KST. Your phone call's coming up next. We're Armstrong and Getty, broadcasting live from the Cal Expo parking lot on Talk 650 KSTE.
Melikilikimaka is a wise way to say merry.
Supplying 100% of the daily adult requirement for talk, we're the Talk Station, Talk 650 KSTE.
On a bright Hawaiian Christmas day, that's the island greeting that...
Hey, Brenda and Deb here.
You know, A-N-P.
Skay-N-P.
Somebody calls and you no pay.
Okay, we're going to go with three incoming calls.
The all-new Talk 650 KSTE.
The time is 9:18. Armstrong and Getty on Talk 650 KSTE. Good morning. Partly sunny. Not a cloud in the sky. Sunny this afternoon in 58. It's about 50 degrees right now. We're in the Cal Expo parking lot with the Highway Patrol. Joe has been drinking and driving, actually. Drinking aggressively. You've had a half a bottle of vodka. You realize that? You're really swaying.
Good morning.
The only reason I'm not drinking is because I'm on this flu medication. Actually, I'm glad I'm not, because I'm flying out this afternoon. I don't need to be hungover for that whole thing.
Yeah, and I'm hurting for certain.
But what we're trying to find out here is how alcohol affects you drink by drink, what it does to people when they drive in terms of their reaction time and their coordination. And we're just learning about the whole deal during the holidays when I guess a lot of people get pulled over for drinking and driving this time of year. This is a bad time of year, right?
Yeah, it is. It is a bad time of year. We see an increase in our DUI arrests and DUI crashes definitely during this time.
Actually, he was just mentioning to me, the officer, that get a lot of people coming home from the airport.
Yeah, that is the case. You've seen a lot of them, haven't you?
Come on, Officer Mike. Come on over.
People fly this time of year. You know, I mentioned I was flying. He said, yeah, you get a lot of people coming home from the airport.
Yeah, a lot of times people take these long flights, 5-6 hours from New York or wherever they're coming from, and then they're drinking an hour, so they're 5 or 6 drinks in by the time they land, and they rent a car, and they're driving home or to their family's house, and a lot of times we stop them at night.
I'm staying at a hotel at the airport tonight, so I'm going to get hammered on the plane. Let's go to the phone. Armstrong and Getty, you're on Bob. Talk 650 yeah. KSTE. Good morning. How's it going, Bob?
Pretty good. Yeah, I just wanted to ask the officers... can you people tell any difference between a drunk driver and a driver that's on drugs?
They have objective symptoms that are different. Sometimes they act the same as far as their coordination, their ability to make decisions, their speech, but they do have some different objective signs that we look for.
Do you have any way to give like a drug test on the highway instead of an alcohol test?
No, we don't have a specific test like a breathalyzer that will measure the drugs. However, we do have experts on our department that will actually put them through another series of field sobriety tests to kind of determine what drug they're on.
I see.
Hey, thanks a lot, Bob. Appreciate the phone call. You know, I got a question. I know when I went through a DUI checkpoint a couple weeks ago, and they asked me if you had anything to drink tonight. They didn't ask if I'd smoked a giant one-foot blunt.
No, they don't. Usually, if you do, and especially in the car, we're going to smell it.
Uh-huh.
So we know what to look for, what kind of smells to look for or smell, and it just takes a trained officer. An officer's going to look for those things.
All right. Robert, you're on Talk 650 KSTE. Good morning, Robert.
Yeah, I have a question about where I could possibly get a breathalyzer for personal use. You know, when you go over to the bar or whatever, you have a couple drinks. You're not sure if you're all right to drive. You know, just to be on the safe side, it'd be kind of nice to have one of those on hand.
Can you get a breathalyzer for personal use? I think that every bar should have one. I think they should put them in cars.
That's a stupid question. You want to fight?
it's one of those things. Best place to look is online. They have They have all kinds of companies that sell them. They don't sell them just to officers.
Sell them? Okay, check on the internet. Okay,
yeah, the only hard part is to maintain them.
Okay,
you have to maintain and continually calibrate them.
I appreciate that.
Okay.
But thank you, our dog. Hey, before we get onto that, Mr. I'm in control.
Yes.
You know, the chart does exist. So if you're X 100 pounds or whatever, you can figure out how many drinks you're probably over the line.
Sure. Hey, Matt, you're on Talk 650 KSTE. We appreciate you holding through the commercials. What's your question, Matt?
Yes, the question I had is for Officer Mike was that if you're passed out in your car and your keys are still in the ignition, are you still going to jail?
You're passed out in your car, your keys are in the ignition, but you're stopped. What's the story there?
Yeah, there is a law in place for that. In or about a vehicle, in a roadway, or in, because DUI applies everywhere, private and public property.
So if you're in your own driveway.
If you're in your own driveway and you're passed out and we have to make contact, there is a possibility you will go to jail.
I don't know why. You're really drunk if you couldn't make it into the house from there, but...
Come on, you made it that far.
All right, well, thanks, Matt. I hope that doesn't apply to you too often. You decided to...
I don't think I'm going to make it clear to the house.
Okay, let's get one more call from Joanna.
I'm in the mood to do some obstacle horse driving. Can we do that?
Okay, we'll do that. You kill that drink while we talk to Joanne.
Oh, God, I don't know if I can.
Joanne, you're on with Armstrong and Getty Talk 650. Good morning.
Hi there. I wanted to ask Officer Mike, something happened to me that I never thought was kind of fair, and I wanted to ask, if you're a driver, a passenger, in a car, and the driver gets pulled over, are you liable to get put in jail as well if you're inebriated?
No, but we suggest you don't be inebriated as a passenger also.
I'll tell you what happens, because it happened to me once. I was with a girl, and she got hauled off to jail, and I was left standing there on the side of the road. They took the car, they took her, and I was just left there.
Did you get laid?
They handcuffed me and put me in the back seat of the car.
Yeah, well, what we would do, generally for passenger, especially female passenger, we would take you to a place of safety and drop you off. A lot of times the passengers that are inebriated, though, they get argumentative and they get out of the car and argumentative and they go to jail for being drunk in public.
Ah, you idiots.
Listen, you technicality, harping on wench. You're a drunk woman and they can't have you drive home, obviously. They're going to do something to keep you safe, all right?
Okay.
Do you want a kiss?
Yeah.
You know, you don't sound drunk, Joe.
Yeah, buddy.
Let's do that. The test, the physical test with the hand slapping.
Okay.
This is one of the tests that they
Scotty
do.
Scotty boy, come here.
One of the stupid human tricks they'll have you do alongside the road if they pull you over weaving and think maybe you've had too much to drink.
All right, here, Scott, take the mic. Jack, let me take a little sip of the drink.
And I'll hold your drink. Boy, you really reek alcohol right now, by the way.
I wonder why.
You smell horrible.
Okay, we're gonna do a real quick test called hand pat. Are you right-handed or left-handed, or do you remember?
Both.
You're both. Put your right hand out like this.
Yes, sir.
Put your left hand out on top like this, palm to palm. Now, what we're going to do, don't do the test, don't start, just watch. You're going to count one for down, two for up.
Okay.
You're going to start off slowly and pick up your speed so it looks like this. One. I want to see you hitting the blade edges of your hand, or double patting, or rolling your hand. Just nice, easy pats. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two.
No problem. I got little kids. I do patty cake all the time.
Okay, go for it.
One, two, one, two. One, two, 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 one, two. Hey, everybody.
Hey.
That was weak.
That was weak. He's that. Double patting, he's rolling, he's...
One, two, one, two.
Yeah, yeah, that looks ugly.
Listen, I'll do better next time, mister.
Do people, when you pull them over and they're drunk, say if somebody's as drunk as he is, here's your drink, sir.
Thank you, buddy.
If somebody's as drunk as he is, do they at some point just give up? I mean, you know, if you fall over when you're standing on one foot, you can't walk the line, do people just say, that's all right, I give up, I'm drunk?
Yeah, we have that all the time. They said, oh, you got me, I'm wasted, just take me to jail where I belong.
That's a good
because
citizen.
Like in the situation you're in, what are you going to keep trying to claim that you're all right?
Oh, yeah. Well, that test was a little unfair because I started to go real fast at the end.
Right. All right, drunkie.
Yeah. Well, how fast do you have to go? Come here. Here, take the microphone again.
Get out your nightstick. I've seen him like this before.
He's getting bad.
You cop, you think you're so tough.
Okay, try it again.
One, two. 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 One, two.
That is bad.
Here.
That is bad.
Have Jack do it. Go ahead. Here,
okay,
give me your mic.
Yeah, I'll try. Go ahead. Like this?
Just like this, yeah.
Count. One, two.
He's just lucky.
Yeah, he's just lucky.
I'm lucky I haven't had 6 ounces of vodka. I'm lucky.
Ouch, that is unbelievable.
We're taking your phone calls at 576-1KST or #650 on your AT&T wireless. Anything you've ever wanted to ask a California Highway Patrolman about drinking and driving? what it's like to get pulled over and how it affects you and the breathalyzer test. So hopefully you haven't gone through it, and hopefully you never will.
All right, now listen, maybe I'm drunk, but I'm taking a look at the drink chart guide here from the CHP. Man of roughly 200 pounds, last time I had the guts to get on the scale. A couple of drinks, I'm okay. Three drinks, I'm in a gray area. This is in a two-hour period. Five, definitely over the line. How about your sexy little wife who used to weigh between 110 to 129? She's now 130 to 149. And, you know, who can blame her? Three drinks, she's over. She's over. She's not your designated driver anymore.
You know, and that's, you know, it's not too hard to imagine somebody stopping after work at TGIF or whatever and having three drinks in an hour and a half period before they head home, and then, you're over the line.
Yeah, that's possible, and that's commonly what happens. That's why we have a lot of high DUI arrest here.
Okay, I want to drive. People who are parking here to watch the drunkenness are pulling away. I need to do some driving.
Okay, let's take a phone call from Steve. Did you finish your drink?
Not quite.
No.
You ought to hammer that down. Don't waste alcohol. That's alcohol abuse, all right? Let's take a phone call from Steve. Talk 650 KSTE. Good morning, Steve.
Good morning, guys. You guys are just busting me out.
You ought to see Joe. He's really weaving. He's standing there drinking and rocking back on his heels.
Oh, and that last half a drink went down pretty good.
Hey, you know what? I heard that if you take a penny and you put it in your mouth in your mouth when you take the breathalyzer test, mm-hmm. and you blow, that it fools the breathalyzer. Is that really true?
Penny saved is a penny earned.
It does, so go out and just get as drunk as you want and just make sure you got a penny. Officer, does that work? Probably not.
No, it doesn't. It doesn't work.
None of those tricks work, right? I mean, I've heard, you know, you carry breath mints or you chew gum or you carry a penny, and none of that works, right?
No, that doesn't work. And first of all, the officer's going to ask you, hey, you got anything in your mouth? Let me see. Okay, spit it out.
What kind of sober person sits around sucking on pennies?
No, not very many.
God, I'd rather go to the drunk tank than put a penny in my mouth anyway. Joe is going to drive again. Oh, Scott's in the back seat. That's nice. That way, two-thirds of the show can be wiped out once.
Here's one of your signs. I didn't know Scott was in the back seat.
That is a sign you're drunk.
I could have killed him. Jesus Christ, Scott. He could have been one leg in, one leg out. I would have ripped off the 30 miles per hour.
Oh, God. That's funny. Okay, Joe's at the beginning of the obstacle course and get ready to go through it again. This is he's pretty drunk now.
You know, the rules of drama dictate we ought to do this after the commercial break.
And it is time to take a break. Let's let you sit there.
All right.
Let the alcohol soak in a little longer. Last time you hit two cones. I want you to go through good and fast this time, by the way.
And, honey, if you're listening, you know, our marriage, it's time to revitalize it a little bit. Come on by.
Armstrong and Getty, we're in the parking lot of Cal Expo at Talk 650 KSTE.
I'll be home for Christmas.
Hello! Thanks, welcome to the show.
It's 9:35, 25 before 10 with Armstrong and Getty. Talk 650 KSTE. We're broadcasting live from the Cal Expo parking lot. We're with the Highway Patrol doing a little demonstration here where Joe is now pretty damn drunk, drinking screwdrivers all morning long, and now he's going to run the obstacle course in the car, and we'll see how. What's his blood alcohol level, you reckon, now?
We haven't blown one for a while, yak boy. Oops.
Control
of the wheel there. Let's do one before I drive, eh, one?
Okay, don't run into anything.
My car is sitting there. I do not
want to hit your own car.
No, head on my own car.
Yeah, it's a good idea. Blow now, because I think you're pretty drunk.
I'm pretty buzzed. Yeah, you know, I am not irresponsible, babbling, saying stuff that doesn't make sense. Drunk. I'm just really, really buzzed.
That made no sense.
Shut up, Scott. Well, I will fight you.
And certainly if you're talking to somebody else just as drunk, you'd have a lovely conversation.
All right, before we get into the breathalyzer, let's ask Officer Nick, what does it cost a guy who gets busted for a basic DUI?
Well, you're talking about no attorneys or anything, just pleading guilty. You're talking $2,500 and above.
Holy crap, $2,500 for pleading guilty.
That's nothing. Oh, yeah. That's the insurance is what's going to kill you.
Yeah, the insurance is going to kill you tremendously. I mean, it goes up. It triples, if not quadruples, for insurance.
And for a long, long time, years and years, right, before you get that off your record?
Definitely.
So you're talking $5,000-$6,000 insurance plus $2,500 for the pleading guilty? Good.
No, it's easily a $10,000 mistake.
See, no one realizes you have all kinds of classes you have to attend, too, and then you got to work work project that you have to pay for. You're going to have to pay to wear that orange suit and pick garbage up off the freeway now.
So you're looking at the down payment of a house or, you know, a new car or whatever.
How do you feel about 15 grand for having a couple too many drinks and driving?
That is I decided a long time ago. That's a lot of cab rides.
You know what it is? You know what it is? It's sobering.
But, you know, a lot of times, cabs, $15, $12 or whatever. Well, that's a hell of a lot cheaper. That's a lot of cab rides. $12,000.
All right. Blow me, Officer Nick.
Oh, man.
Give me your baton. I'm going to give him one right in the back of the neck, a rabbit punch.
Here we go.
Got to do the breathalyzer and just see how drunk he is. You're swaying sitting in the car.
Scott, how are you doing in the back?
I'm scared.
If a guy,
he can't stop laughing.
If a guy has to take 2-3 tries to take a deep breath, does that, you know, factor in?
Can't stop laughing long enough to
Scott,
blow the breath away.
Shut up back there.
Of course, it wouldn't be as funny if you're as 2 o'clock in the morning, you're alongside the road, and you're wondering what the hell you're going to tell your wife.
You're a 1-1 right now, and that's pretty accurate.
You're a 1-1.
1-1.
Okay.
It's pretty drunk.
And point one was the old measure, right?
Yeah, that was the old measure. Everyone was under the influence at a point one. Now it's point 0.08, and that's just for anybody over 21.
You know, I've got to admit, when I read that in the newspaper, I thought, point 0.08, isn't that a little low? But I'm at a point 1-1, and I'm drunk.
Right.
I should not be driving.
How about when you hear of people getting pulled over and you hear that they were a 2-0 or whatever? I mean, how can you even be on your feet when you're that drunk?
Jeez, all right. Listen, you
hey,
keep
you're about
talking,
to
I'm going
to
pull over.
Speaking of feet, you about ran ours over.
Yeah, well, back up.
Okay, off Joe goes in the highway patrol car and going to go through the obstacle course in a pretty drunk state.
Let's I'm handing off the mic to Officer Mike.
Let's take a phone call real quick. You're on with Armstrong and Getty Talk 650 KSTE. Good morning. What can we do for you?
Oh, I just thought, I'm just thinking about how much money it would cost. But it's another thing, what happens after you get incarcerated or you go down to the tank. You can stay there for up to 24 hours. Until you're assigned a cell, and in that 24 hours, you don't get an attorney and you can't talk to relatives.
Right.
It's I had to bail a guy out. Or actually, he finally had the charges dropped because they were unfounded. But it was a tremendous embarrassment, a big hassle, and the guy was just scared to death.
Yeah, I mean, you know, there's plenty of people that have jobs where if you got a DUI, you're probably going to lose your job. So it can be very expensive. All right,
let's
good call.
Take
thanks
more
a lot.
More calls from horny women.
All right, any horny women want to call? Joe's Randy because he's crazy drunk. He's had
yes, I am.
Half a bottle of vodka. Okay, let's send you on through the cones.
Right.
Drive.
All right, Fitzwell, you going to do play by play?
Yeah.
All right.
Take off. Last time he hit 2 cones. We'll see how he does this time. And don't go real slow. I want you to hit it pretty good. Okay, he's not driving as fast as he has before. I mean, he's like jerking, stopping his car. He's going a lot slower. Now he's going a lot faster. Didn't hit any cones.
Wow.
Stopped a little soon and a little jerky, a little abrupt, but didn't hit any cones. Backed into one. Now it's the parallel parking test. He's also concentrating a lot harder than he has earlier because he's not talking at all.
Yeah, I noticed that.
No cones.
There we go. How good was that?
Pretty good.
Not too bad.
It was a little herky-jerky in the beginning.
All right, let's try it again.
Okay.
Ask
Scott if he has whiplash.
All right, Scott?
Yeah, I'm getting whiplash back here.
You want it a little faster and a little smoother?
You were a little herky-jerky through the beginning. I mean, a little stop. It hurt.
Why don't you go ahead and talk like you were before on the radio you're doing it.
All right,
by play.
Here we go, Officer Nick. There we go.
Here he goes through again.
Right cone, left cone. Oh, dead cone.
Ran over a cone.
Ran over a cone. Here we go. Let's do the serpentine.
Woo!
Woo!
He didn't hit the cone.
How did the windshield wipers go on?
I don't know why you're running the windshield wipers. It's sunny and clear.
All right. Again, turn off the windshield wipers. Who did that?
You did.
Shut up.
Drinky.
Uh-oh. There's the horn. All right. Pretty good.
Yeah, that was pretty good. Pretty good. You only hit one cone. Yeah, you ran the windshield wipers and hit the horn once, which is perfectly
normal. Yeah, but I hit the first cone. Yeah. How can you possibly hit that cone?
It's hard to imagine.
Scott, get out and produce that cone being on its front.
let's go to the phone. You're on with Armstrong and Getty. Talk 650. Good morning. What can we do for you?
Yes, I'd like to ask the officer what would happen if I refused to take the test.
Ah, good question. You get pulled over.
Yes.
They say, we'd like you to blow into this or follow my finger, and you just say no. What happens then?
Yes.
Well, if you say no, then we're going to have to, based on everything we've got already, your driving, your objective symptoms, you're probably going to go to jail. If you don't give us a chance to give you a field sobriety test, we're not going to take the chance of letting you out there drinking and driving. So we're going to take you down to the county jail, and then if you refuse that test, Sacramento County has a no-refusal policy. We're going to take you down to another area, and we're going to forcibly take that blood. Normally what happens is we keep you handcuffed, we bring a licensed phlebotomist, they come down, and they're going to take the blood. We're going to use as many officers to hold you down to take the blood, but it's all videotaped, and we're going to make sure we do it within reason.
That sounds like a pleasant process, doesn't it?
I don't want
anybody... Where's the breathalyzer? I didn't take a breathalyzer. I demand a breathalyzer.
I don't want anybody forcibly...
You were a 1-1.
Is there a commercial ring?
I did take one. You did.
I hear something on the... What I hear? I hear another radio station.
That's I do too. Is it any good? Maybe I'll listen to it.
So they'll forcibly take your blood if you refuse to test. I don't want anybody forcibly taking
blah,
your blood.
Blah, blah, blah.
And here's the bad thing. When it's all said and done, you're still a refusal. Even though we got the blood, we're going to get it anyways. You're still going to be seen as a refusal, and you're going to have to pay the extra fines and the extra time.
And a 1-year suspension on top of that automatically.
Just for refusing?
Just for a refusal. Automatic 1-year suspension.
Okay. That's a raw deal.
Well...
Even if you get off of the DUI charge, you're still going to, the DMV will still suspend your license for a year.
Why in the world would you ever refuse to take the test?
Oh, that is unbelievable. That's a message for you folks.
Sure. You all right?
What do you mean?
I wish we had some music going. I'd like to see you dance.
Dance, Rummy. Randy, then. What was I just a couple of minutes ago, Officer Mike?
0.11. I'd like to say one thing. As you know, as his alcohol intoxication got higher, his driving got more aggressive.
Right.
And that's the problem that we have out there. When you're sober, you're driving, you're more cognizant of what you're doing. As he got higher in his blood alcohol concentration, his driving got a lot more aggressive.
That's what people do?
And that's common, and that's what causes the accidents. You're coming around the curve, you're a little bit hot in the curve, you lose control of the car, you can't correct it.
And listen, I didn't do that intentionally either. I was just trying to drive as aggressively as possible, like I did the first time through the course, to set a time. And it's... What were you laughing at? God, I will fight you so quick.
None of us are laughing at anything.
But the point is, as aggressively as possible, got more and more aggressive.
Sure. We're laughing at you.
Not with me.
Right.
That's good. That's comforting. Let's blow another breathalyzer, shall we? Because it's been, 5-6 minutes?
Jesus, are you slurring? I mean, honest to God.
Here, you know what I want to see?
You just knocked over your
coffee.
I
just knocked over my coffee.
Knocked over his coffee.
Let me see Captain Wiseass put on the drunk goggles here.
Yeah,
what's the story on these, Officer Nick? I almost called him Officizer. Good morning.
These are drunk goggles, fatal vision goggles, and they simulate being under the influence of alcohol. These ones are calibrated probably a 1.8.
Oh, so this is really drunk.
Yeah, this is drunk. This is where you'll be in a little while.
This is Jack Armstrong drunk.
This is Dean Martin drunk.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Hey, do the eyeball thing with him, because I think he's a little,
Yeah, I'll do the eyeball
thing. A little
thing.
Down the road.
That's when you hold your finger out and I have to follow your finger?
Oh, here's the breathalyzer. Let me do that.
How does he look?
Intoxicated.
What is he?
I'm 0.94. I'm still below the old legal limit. That's frightening.
Is he really?
Yeah, he's 0.09. What's happening is it was too soon after that last drink, so he still has some mouth residue alcohol, so that's why
I
registered 1-1.
That's unbelievable.
Yeah, it's been, almost 15 minutes since the last drink, so that's probably the most accurate reading right now. 0.09. Oh, nine.
Honest to God, people, I'm a man who drinks. I enjoy a cocktail now and then. I should not be driving.
And that used to be legal, to be as drunk as you are. You can hardly talk in driving around.
Talking, all right. Peter Piper picked a pick of pickle puppers.
Do the sixth sheik
sick. The sheik sheik sixth sheep sick. The
there
sixth
you go.
Sheep. But I talk for a living. That's unfair. Peter Piper picked a bag of pickled peppers. Peck a pickle pepper.
Hey, I got a good one. I got a win. Can you get an erection?
Again, we lack a woman. Is there an X chromosome to be found?
I bet that's where the drinking would really show up. Okay, I'm going to put on the goggles.
Oh, my God.
Now, strap them on your dome there.
Oh, Jesus, I'm about to fall over.
Yeah, right?
Have you put these on?
No.
These goggles that
I
make
I don't
you,
need them.
These goggles that make it simulate that... Oh, geez, these things are scary. Did you try this, Scott?
Here, let me try them.
Okay, well, I can't walk the line because I can't see the line.
Of course, it's double strong. Oh, look at you. Look, you're an embarrassment. Hey, try...
Jesus, that's
one
unbelievable.
One step at a time there.
That's unbelievable. Wow, that's something. And that's what'd you say? Right. How drunk?
That's 1/8. That's over twice the legal limit.
So that's hammered.
Let me try that, Officer
you
Mike.
You definitely shouldn't be driving if that's your eyesight. Try and walk the straight line with those on and being drunk. That puts you at like a 6'2".
Oh, my God.
You're Janis Joplin drunk now.
All right, I'm Lynyrd Skynyrd drunk. Here we go. Hey. Oof. Erf. Take those away from me, Mike.
All right, we've got to take a break. We'll squeeze in a few more of your phone calls when we come back at 5761-KST. You can talk to the Highway Patrolman and ask a question. Ask Joe a question when he's really drunk. He might give you an answer he wouldn't normally give you.
That's a great idea.
Maybe Judy should call up. 5761-KST. We're Armstrong and Getty. Stay with us. We're at the Cal Expo parking lot with the Highway Patrol, and Joe's drunk. We'll explain later.
Doesn't show signs of stopping, and I brought me some corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low. Let it snow.
Armstrong and Getty.
Insulting, embarrassing, obscene,
immature. Early mornings on the talk station.
Wow.
Talk 650 KSTE.
The Sacramento
Talk Station. The all-new Talk 650 KSTE.
Hi there. Welcome back. Armstrong and Getty. Good morning. We're on vacation next week, so we won't talk to you all again until the year 2001. We're in the parking lot of Cal Expo. Joe is pretty damn drunk. The reason for that is we're here with the California Highway Patrol, and we're finding out how alcohol affects you in terms of driving and doing the whole breathalyzer thing, and hoping that you'll listen to this and realize maybe I should get a cab, maybe I should have a designated driver before you go to that holiday party.
Yeah, before you start drinking, make the decision, because frankly, I wouldn't trust me with any decision at this point.
Say that again in English.
What was my last breathalyzer? I don't remember.
It was 09.
God, it's just barely over the legal limit.
Yeah.
Good Lord. And, you know, I am not a 18-year-old college freshman either. I've had a couple of cocktails.
Right, it's not like you're new to the grape.
Yeah, and the thing is, you're still going up.
That's a good point. What do you mean?
Your alcohol level's still going up. Even though you had your last drink about 15 minutes ago, your body's still absorbing that alcohol.
So half an hour from now, I'll be drunker?
Oh, definitely. You're going to be somewhere in the 1-3, right? About 1-2, 1-3 range.
But luckily, you'll be sleeping in a pool of your own vomit by then. Let's go to the phone. Armstrong and Getty, you're on with us on Talk 650. Good morning. Hello.
Hello.
And what can we do for you?
I'm just wondering. I have a friend that's not a heavy drinker. Enjoys a few glasses of wine over dinner, say 3 or 4.
3 or 4 glasses of wine with dinner?
Uh-huh.
That's pretty good drinking. But anyway, what's the question?
Would he be legal to drive? 200-pound person.
He's in that gray area. Okay. He's definitely in that gray area. I wouldn't suggest he drive, but... he may not be quite an 08, but like I said, it's that gray area.
And yeah, but what you're saying, he's not immediately arrestable, but it's definitely a bad idea that he's driving.
Okay.
Yeah, it is a definitely. Any amount of alcohol is going to affect you.
Uh-huh.
But everyone's over the legal limit at 08 or above.
Okay.
And that's what you have to remember. It's going to affect your reaction time, so he shouldn't be driving. He really shouldn't. And what's alcohol do? That he may not stop at 3 and 4 one day. He may end up going 5 or 6 or 7, and before you know it, he's behind the wheel.
Absolutely.
All right, let's blow a level here. Happy holiday, sweetheart.
Joe's going to blow into the breathalyzer. You polished off about a half a bottle of vodka.
Went down smooth. It's Svedka vodka.
It's good stuff. What do you blow?
Ryzen BAC of 0.11 right now.
0.11.
Yeah, buddy.
So he's off to the Huskow. Gonna cuff him.
Oh, yeah.
I don't like the looks of him. I think a little nightstick to the back of the knees. Keep him in line. Let's take another phone call. You're on Talk 650 KSTE. Good morning. How are you?
Good morning.
What can we do for you?
This is your wife.
Oh,
hi,
sweetheart.
How drunk you are.
I'm sorry, what was that?
I'm wondering how drunk you are.
Just pleasantly buzzed.
No drunker than the young man you fell in love with.
What are you doing in like half an hour?
Well, I'm painting the Christmas presents.
Now, why don't you put on something pretty? He's
painting Christmas presents. What the hell? Listen, honey, meet me at home in like half an hour, would you?
Okay.
I've got a little present I'd like to give you.
I'm not sure you can get it wrapped, though.
I'm sorry, what was that?
You're sounding a little randy.
I am feeling a little randy, honey. I'll have Scott drive me home. You and I need to rediscover what brought us together.
I think you'll find him sleeping is what you'll find.
Oh, no.
He's probably going to pass out the moment he hits the bed.
No, be there by 10:20, honey, and we will, yeah. All right. I love you.
Love you, too.
Bye-bye.
He's got a very sexy smell going.
Oh, shut up. Listen, dude, just because you're not getting any doesn't mean you have to deny the rest of the world.
Okay, let's take another phone call. Talk 650 KSTE. Good morning. You're on with Armstrong and Getty.
Yes, good morning. This is Mo.
Hey, Mo.
Hello,
how's
Mo.
It going?
Joe's drunk. How are you?
Oh, no complaints. Looking forward to the holiday season.
Mm-hmm.
Good man.
I got a couple of questions for the officer.
All right.
One is, can you get a DUI while you're riding a bicycle?
Yeah, you can. You can get a DUI for riding a bicycle. It's a misdemeanor.
Okay.
Because you create the same hazard on the roadway as a car would. You're drunk, you veer into traffic, you're going to cause that car to veer away from you and cause a collision and potentially kill somebody.
Alrighty.
How the hell would you get pulled over?
Oh, CHP stops a lot of bikes out there.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Doing what? What are they doing?
Riding their bike the wrong way,
okay.
Right in the middle of the roadway, weaving, light out at night. There's a lot of reasons.
No kidding, all right.
We always read about power mowers, too. You're riding mowers? Drunk guys driving that, it's hard to imagine, isn't it? you just take over there. You handle it.
We just got a couple minutes left in the show, left in the year, and it seems like we ought to have some sort of a holiday salute to all you good people who listen throughout the year and hope you come back in the year 2001.
Yeah, God bless you. Thank you for, you just take over.
You've got that real heartfelt buzz going.
Keep talking.
Come on. You could say...
Keep talking.
You could say...
More to my hand.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's a sad picture. To see a man like this. The depths of drunkenness.
Oh, boy. It says you. You're going to be flying today.
Yeah.
You're looking at like 14 different delays and canceled flights.
Yeah, I'll be in your condition when I get to the Sacramento airport here in a couple hours. I hope. Well, thanks, everybody who listened during the year 2000, and we look forward to serving you in the year 2001 when
yes,
you all come back.
Yes, we do. We do indeed.
Hey, get in the car and let's run them through one more time. We got 1 minute.
Let's
end the year with Joe driving the car through the...
Here, Officer Mike,
take this right now.
Let's end the year with Joe driving through the course one more time. Give us the music, Michael. Little Chariots of Fire music as Joe gets in the car, drunker in hell, to go through the course.
Can't find it.
He's not even going to be able to... He's not even going to be able to buckle his seatbelt before we run out of time. He's an embarrassment. Really, isn't he?
Oh, yeah. That's scary.
Hey, Merry Christmas, a-hole.
There he goes. This is sad. We got 30 seconds. You're going to have to step on it, Ace.
And, honey, if you thought I was kidding, I'm not. Make it home. Ready? Go!
Hasn't hit a cone yet. Hit a cone. One cone down. There he goes through the serpentine.
Oh!
Oh. Lost it. Hit another cone. Drug a cone for a while. Oh! Forgot to stop. Forgot to hit another cone and another cone. Bye, everybody. We'll see
several cones later.
Happy holidays, everybody.
We'll see you, Armstrong and Getty. Talk 650 KSD.
Well, is met with a resounding thud. At least for the president of...